Hi, my name is Ted Heil. I'm the president of Mini Circuits, and I welcome you to the Mini Circuits IMS booth. Unfortunately, we're not able to be on site in LA. Quite a few things have changed in the last 6 months, and as a result, we are changing how we present our products and our services and updates on the business to you. Today, I am presenting you our booth from our corporate headquarters in Brooklyn, New York City. The last several months have been amazing in so many different ways, and just like everyone else, Mini Circuits has adapted and we have actually done quite well. We'll be talking to you about the products that we have worked on and that we have introduced over this period of time, but I'd also like to introduce you to a few other of the advances that we made outside of products. 2020 has been a year of investment for us. We have been fortunate to come off of a couple of years of extraordinary growth, record-setting sales that have afforded us the ability to continue those investments. In the last 6 months or the last year, we have opened a new development office in Rhode Island where we're developing our advanced power amplifiers. Some of those products are on display today and I'll talk a little bit about them. We've also broke ground on a clean room facility in our Long Island location. That's going to enable us to take our modules, our amplifiers and passive products up into the deep millimeter wave, up beyond the 40, 50, 60 gigahertz into the 110 gigahertz range. We've also made investments in services. This year we onboarded Mauser as a distributor. That's a change in the Mini Circuits go-to-market model. A lot of our customers wanted more flexibility in the way they buy our parts. So we changed from a US only through New York or only through Mini Circuits model to adding Mauser as a third-party distributor. We've also opened up sales offices in Europe and in Japan to better service our customers there. And we expanded our fulfillment in Asia with adding a shipping capability direct out of our Penang, Malaysia facility to shorten the lead times and cost structure for all of our customers throughout Asia. So all in all, 2020, in spite of all of the hurdles and difficulty that as an organization and as a world and as an industry we have seen, we've been really fortunate and lucky and through a lot of hard work through the people here at Mini Circuits. So now I'd like to show you some of the results of that effort through looking at several of the key products, areas that we've made investment, and a lot of the good success we've had. The first product line that I'd like to introduce to you today is our low temperature co-fired ceramic products. This includes filters, balance, passives like power splitters and couplers that we introduced into Mini Circuits probably 25 years ago. This product line has expanded prolifically, and I think today we offer the broadest product line of Ltcc components in the industry. It's typically the mainstay of a lot of different engineers. We know we sell it over to 20,000 customers. It's also been a source of continued investment for us. This year we're releasing our millimeter wave versions. This is unique for Mini Circuits that we're able to push our product lines above the 12, 13 gigahertz limits of traditional lumped element structures. We're using a distributed filter technology to be able to offer low pass, band pass, and high pass filters up through 39 gigahertz, setting some of the industry standards for this type of a multi-layer SMT filter product line. We've also enhanced our existing product line that is very popular by reducing the size and the footprint of some of the existing catalog models, reducing them from 1210 and 0805 down to 0402 and 0603, making it easier for our customers to use these filters in tight environments, tight board space environments, and making them overall more flexible and usable. We've also enhanced the rejection, the cutoff frequencies, and the slope in the rejection band is enhanced dramatically. Finally, one of the products that we will be releasing in the next several months before the end of this year is a higher isolation version of these same filters. Starting at 6 gig and running up to about 12, 13 gigahertz, we're able to make LTCC surface mount filters that unbelievably have 60 dB of rejection. That's unprecedented and unparalleled throughout the industry, and is going to serve a lot of our customers who have those tough filtering requirements, who traditionally had to go through off-board solutions or maybe through some high isolation configurations. LTCC continues to be a big source of investment for us. We know it's highly valued by our customers and a product line that we're going to continue to drive new product development over the next several years. MMIC products has been another area of great investment for mini circuits. We focus on two types of products, active and passive. Both we have pushed higher in frequency and wider in coverage in the last 12 months. On the amplifier side, we released our TSS, our first amplifier over 26 gigahertz that operates with shutdown through 43 gigahertz. Over the next several months, you'll see six new designs that are coming out in the bands up to 43.5 gigahertz. These include narrow band low noise amplifiers, medium power amplifiers, and ultra wide band amplifiers. We've also introduced our distributed amplifier product line that is up through 20 gigahertz. These include very, very flat amplifiers, and we've even offered amplifiers with positive slopes to help our customers compensate a traditional negative slope in their systems. Over the next year, you'll see us releasing medium power amplifiers, more in the half watt to 1 watt range. And we will be even developing our product lines up through 67 gigahertz. On the passive side, you've seen us release our extremely wideband power splitters. These are up through 40 gigahertz today. We also introduced a new series of power splitters. These are actually starting as low as DC, from DC to 18 gigahertz. And unlike traditional resistive power splitters, these actually have isolation between the two output ports. It's a new topology that we're in the process of patenting right now. You've also seen the equalizer line grow from what was 6 gigahertz up through 20 gigahertz. These are fixed equalizers that we offer in 1 dB increments. On various different formats. You've seen our balance that we've now released through 20 gigahertz, and our mixers and multipliers, which today are up at 40 gigahertz, and now we'll be pushing through the 60 gigahertz bands. All in all, MMICs have been and will continue to be an area of great success for mini circuits and continued investment. Mini circuits has long supported our customers in their test applications. We have offered a variety of products, connectorized format, so that they can fulfill their test needs on the test bench. One of the most popular is what we bring to the market in terms of amplifiers. Everyone is familiar with our typical black heat sinks that down from very low frequencies up to a few hundred megahertz. But recently we've brought that product line up into the microwave bands and now into the millimeter wave. This year alone, we released a number of amplifiers, some that cover the full band from 50 kilohertz all the way up to 40 gigahertz. We offered medium power and low noise amplifiers connectorized over optimized bands as well. You'll also see a lot of advances coming soon in terms of power amplifiers. A product line that typically plateaued at about 100 watts, now we're going to push that 200 watts and into the kilowatt region. Power amplifiers used for test applications, and we're starting an RF energy market that will begin at 250 watts in some of the popular ISM bands. In continuing support of our customers' test applications, in the last several months, we've introduced a number of products that are test accessories supporting our customers up through 67 gigahertz. These are 1.85 millimeter connectorized products, including cables, adapters, attenuators, even passive products such as couplers and power splitters, narrowband, and even ultra-wideband, going full 0.5 to 60 gigahertz, supporting customers' applications as benchtop, test customized solutions that they need to fulfill their market demand. We've integrated the same products along with the amplifiers and a variety of other products into this full turnkey custom test solution product line. This is now including switches and level control systems up through 40 gigahertz. All in all, 2020, and in spite of the difficulties that the world has seen, including mini circuits, we have had a rather successful year. I credit a lot of that to the people at Mini Circuits here in New York and all over the world for the hard work and dedication that they have provided to make our products and services available to our customers. And I really also want to thank our customers. Throughout this entire time, they have showed their continued value and trust in Mini Circuits in what we bring to them. They have inspired us, and we are looking forward to continuing that relationship through the rest of 2020 and into next year. I look forward to a great time and seeing you all at the next IMS.